The People versus the Klan, coming Sunday, April 11th at 9. Closed captioning brought to you by Gilt. Visit Gilt.com today for up to 70% off designer brands.
At Gilt.com, get insider access to coveted designers like Valentino, Chloe, and Dior at up to 70% off retail prices. Visit Gilt.com today.
All right, thanks so much for joining me today. I'm Frederica Whitfield. But before we end this hour, I want to welcome the newest member of the CNN Weekend Show team, Jim Acosta, anchoring CNN Newsroom right after me now on Saturdays and Sundays. Jim, good to see you. Congratulations. What you got
coming
up?
Thank you, Frederica. Yeah, it's great to be here with you. We've known each other for so long, so it's wonderful to do this handoff with you. We're going to have Dr. Anthony Fauci coming up later on in the show. He's going to be talking about what is being done to get life back to normal in this country. I think that's a key question. That's what everybody wants to know, right? When can we take off these masks and go back to enjoying our lives? So we'll talk about that. I have a lot of other guests coming up later on in this newsroom for today, and looking forward to it. Thanks for having us.
Oh, fantastic. All right. Well, I know the gang is all there and ready to christen you for the weekend, and I'm wishing you the best.
Thanks, Fred.
All right. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Take care.
And you are live in the CNN newsroom. I'm Jim Acosta in Washington, and that is where we begin, in the nation's capital, where the security of the U.S. Capitol is building once again in question after two deadly attacks less than 90 days apart. The latest one carried out by a knife-wielding man who rammed his car into two Capitol police officers, killing one, wounding another, and shocking a city that is still grappling with the events of the January 6th insurrection. While the motive remains unclear, sources tell CNN the 25-year-old suspect had ranted online about the CIA and FBI, claiming he was the victim of mind control. His actions took the life of Officer William Evans, an 18-year veteran of the force and father of two. Flags are now flying at half staff in his honor. And we have a team of reporters up on Capitol Hill covering the latest for us. CNN's Boris Sanchez has new details on the officer who was killed. But let's begin with CNN's Pete Montine, who's learning new details about the suspect and posts that he made, disturbing posts, online prior to the attack. Pete, what can you tell us?
Well, Jim, investigators are just now digging into the past of 25-year-old Noah Green.